the Gulf right now is probably about 15 feet away from our building.
A Fort Myers Beach condo building is on the edge, and this storm likely headed our way could cause part of it to crumble into the Gulf.
We are in dire need of constructing our seawall.
About a dozen feet separate the Leonardo Arms condo building number 2 and the water. A dozen. NBC2's Gage Golding has been covering this story since the start of the hurricane season, and he's live on the beach showing us just how bad the erosion has been.
Yeah, worst case scenario, this building could be heavily damaged or even destroyed. There is so little land that separates the foundation of this 6-story condo building in the Gulf of Mexico that engineers deemed it vulnerable earlier this spring. Now this storm that is coming our way could be the one that causes this damage.
We've been under the threat of one good storm for about a year now.
A year of white-knuckle waiting and wishing a storm wouldn't find Fort Myers Beach in its crosshairs. But for Gene Duffy, that wait might be over. Ian is looking right at his home.
That makes me very nervous because I'm on the first floor.
Duffy is the president of the building's HOA. He's seen his beach shrink nearly 20 times in size.
Years past, we had 300 feet of beach. The Gulf right now is probably about 15 feet away from our building.
Years of erosion have chipped away at the sand. Now only these sandbags are left to fend off the Gulf.
So far, they're doing their job, but a big storm, I don't think they would handle that.
Just a little, you know, nerve-wracking maybe to see. Something like that.
It's that exact looming storm that has Mason Newby and his family cutting their stay short.
Not taking a gamble. If we did get stuck, couldn't really afford to miss that time at the house and work and all that stuff.
There is a plan to protect Leonardo Arms, a seawall, but they can't build it until after sea turtle nesting season.
All we're waiting for is a permit from the state of Florida.
Until then,
we can do nothing. Just wait for a future storm or hurricane to do devastating damage to us.
For the people that live here, this is as real as it gets. All eyes are on the state as they anxiously await their permit to be approved. And I asked the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission, hey, where are we at with this? And they say it's in the works. Actually, they're going to be meeting next week to come up with any recommendations they might have to give to the Florida Department of Environmental Protection. And I reached out to the DEP as well, but tonight I haven't heard back from them yet. I'm reporting live in Fort Myers Beach. Gage Golding, NBC2.